Yo yo, what is going on guys, welcome back in a brand new Assetto Corsa Competizione video. As you can see, we are in Zolder, we are in an open lobby on ACC. I'm trying to do this new type of content, so making voiceovers of Assetto Corsa races. We are in Zolder in a multiplayer open lobby. We invited the first lap in qualifying, we're starting now the second lap of this qualifying. So if you like this type of videos, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel to see more videos like this that I think are really lovely. I don't know. Anyway, into turn one we go for our first valid lap in Zolder. Turn one and turn two very tricky. We couldn't really find any precision there. Really, really tricky. As I said, a bit on the grass there. We lost a lot. Then into turn four we go. We have a bit of confidence, but not too much in the first three corners, to be honest. Now we go into this very, very tricky chicane where you don't, where you want to cut as much as you can without unsettle the car. So it's quite tricky this track, but I really, really like, this is one of the most difficult parts, to be honest. This triple chicane, you need to keep the car rotate through here, and a very fast right-hander. We're doing a pretty good lap. I enjoyed this lap, so heavy braking here. Up gear.
A bit of lag.
We had a bit of lag here, there's a bit of screen freezing that was not ideal, as you could hear of me saying that. The final chicane took very, very easy to not invalidate and to finish this first lap, obviously, that we can improve later. So to the finish line we go, and we do a fantastic lap. The setup in P2, so very, very amazing.
From nowhere.
As you could hear from my reaction, that was totally unexpected, and this happened there. We're starting the final lap of the qualifying. We're trying to improve, and a car just completely went into us at the final chicane. Why? We discussed about it in the Assetto Corsa Competizione chat, and he said because he wanted to do the lap because it was ending the session.
The lap I did, actually.
But yeah, we could be, as I'm saying here, we could be P4, P5, probably, and we're P6, because we could improve a lot. Anyway, this is the race start ready. Try and do a good start, obviously. So is green lights. Now we did actually get a nice start, but not as much as the car side. Such a bad start in some way. The Porsche completely goes into us. We're side by side with him. He is ahead. And now he goes so slow here. We completely went into him. And I said, fuck him. And this is a bit of karma, to be honest. So we'll take it. Let me know in the comments who was full there. I think it's like quite a racing incident because he took that corner so slowly, and he completely went into us into turn one. Then the BMW behind tried to went into us into, you know, trying to overtaking us into that chicane, but it's pretty impossible. We're struggling here. We're trying to defend a position. So hard on the curbs, and we spun. And we spun with a bit of contact with that BMW as well. So now we're starting recovering time, gaining time. We're nothing to lose at the point. Now we are P8. So again in this chicane, very, very nicely here. There's a slow car ahead. That is the Porsche that we went probably into it. I think we have a car crash there. We are up to P8. We were P9. I think, or maybe it was a lapped car, I don't know, to be honest. So, again, here, we're trying to find times. We completely cut the chicane because we find quite traffic. We did a bit of mistake there. All the cars are there now, 16 minutes ago. So in 2 minutes, we recovered all the group in some way. So we have to pass this Mercedes car down the inside. Almost went into the BMW there.
Let's go into the
side BMW. By side now. With the Mercedes, we try and keep the line. We push him so wide. This was completely my fault. So I apologize for that if this Mercedes is watching this video. So yeah, it was completely my fault. I forced the entry. Then I have a very good exit through here. I try to quite making pressure on the BMW. I think about that move, but then I said, to pass in that chicane is a bit, you know,
they will make contact
a bit of,
we
would kill ourselves, to be honest. Now the Porsche did a mistake, trying to do a very good switchback, and then here, I think again of that move, but it was impossible on the inside in that corner. So, right now, I want just to follow the cars ahead, and I do this crazy scent, that to be honest,
from nowhere, bye bye man, bye bye, have a good coffee,
so I didn't want to really scent it. Now we stay completely on the inside to try and regain the position in some way. It really reminds me, Leclerc with Perez in Baku, to try and stay to the inside. Now the Porsche just a few meters ago did a mistake, so we gained so much time.
We're starting struggling the Porsche.
And yeah, basically we were so faster, we were struggling a lot to keep the car on the track. We think about the move here, but probably not. We're just making pressure, trying to have the best exit through here. We're so close to the Porsche now as we go downhill in this third right, left, and right under again. Triple chicane. So he did a mistake. Very good switchback. Very optimistic in closing the door there. And so he had to lift off again as well. And so we basically say bye bye to everyone. Up to P4. What a recovery drive. Then we do this very stupid mistake. We almost sent into the barrier, and the BMW is really close to us as well. And he hit us for no reason, to be honest. But with this move, actually, we can maintain the position. So yeah, he tries this move around the outside. A few laps later, in turn one, he completely crashed. He completely went into the gravel there. He lost lots of time there, and we could maintain the speed for.
I think it's just a bit of brake bias. Such unstable the car.
Yeah, it was a very big moment. We almost retired, to be honest. I don't know why, like, no damage or.
P3 driver, yes it is.
And now we crashed after a mistake he did. He probably had car damage as well, I think,
maybe,
I'm not sure.
Damage,
we crashed the P3 driver, so the BMW driver that was running in P3. We're trying to have a very good switchback here at the chicane. We have a much better exit. We easily pass him. And we are P3.
P3 boys.
So now 5 minutes to go and the BMW of Arthur, one of my fans, as you can see, is P4, and he was catching us a lot. So I was doing some mistakes going into the gravel. It was not easy. And like I said here, we have to defend for 5 minutes. 1 minute to go now. 1 minute to go will be the last lap of this race. We have Arthur really, really close to us. He was faster. He did pole position. He's so fast. And now we have to do like we did in Hungary. I will leave you the link in the description. We did a master defense for like 10 or 15 minutes. As if you saw that video, we have to redo it just for 1 minute in a much faster driver. This time as well, 44 seconds to go. We try to defend. We know how to defend, so it will not be that hard. But it will be hard to not do a mistake with this type of pressure.
He deserves this P3 because it's faster. Much faster than us. He deserves the win, probably.
So, yeah, he started on pole. I think he crashed with someone. So that's why he had to recover all these places up to the P3 that he can get.
Tactics. Strategies. We have the best exit here. He had a better exit, he's much faster than us. Much faster than
now us. We stay in the middle of the track, that is the best defensive strategy. I will might do a video if you want on how to defend in general in racing simulators. We got a good exit here, we gained just a bit of meters that are enough to defend here. We completely go to the inside and defending and then switching back to the outside to have a better line to exit this corner.
For the last corner.
And yeah, he doesn't really have a much better exit. We completely cover the inside, try to have a better exit by switching to the middle of the track. We brake so deep, we're trying to cover the switchback and try to defend from this.
Oh, come on, come on, come on. Yes, we did it. Oh, P3.
And we did a fantastic, incredible, unpredictable P3. We did one of our best races on ACC, maybe our best, because we did such good overtakes, such a good pace, to be honest, and a good defense at the end. This was everything. There was everything in this race, overtaking space and a big defense at the end. So I hope you liked this video. Please don't forget to smash the like button, subscribe to the channel. As always, it's been a pleasure. Cheers!